This video is an example of using the binomial probability distribution. A certain insecticide kills 70% of all insects in laboratory experiments. A sample of 8 insects is exposed to the insecticide in a particular experiment. What is the probability that exactly one insect will survive? I'm going to also extend this problem to find the probability that at most 3 survive and more than 5 survive. So first I'm going to identify the pieces that I need. I need the sample size, and that's n. I have 8 insects. I need the probability of success. Now this problem is a little bit sneaky. It gives 70% here, but that's not my probability of success. It's not what we're looking for, because it says 70% of all insects are killed, but they want survival. Okay, they want the probability that one will survive. So I want to focus on the probability of survival. If the probability of the insecticide killing is 0.7, then the probability that the insecticide does not kill would be 0.3. Okay, so when you're working a homework problem, you want to make sure that what you're looking for in the problem matches your probability of success. Okay, most of the time the homework problems are more straightforward than this. I picked this one because it had this little extra bit of sneakiness here. All right, and then I also want to recognize the fact that X is going to take on values 0 up through 8, okay, where 0 is that no insects survive, 1, exactly 1 insect survives, 2 survive, up to all 8 surviving. All right, so to answer the first part, I want to find the probability that X is exactly 1 surviving. I'm going to use my calculator's built-in binomial probability function for this, but if you wanted to do this by hand, the formula would be 8 choose 1 times the probability of success raised to the X power times the probability of failure raised to the n minus x power, which would be 7. Okay, so these two exponents need to add to the sample size, and the exponent on the probability of survival or probability of success needs to match this number here. Okay, so if you wanted to go ahead and do this by hand, you could. It's pretty straightforward when you want to find the probability that X takes on an exact value. Okay, it does become more cumbersome when you have a less than or greater than type of situation. Okay, so you could certainly do this by hand. 8 choose 1 is just 8. And you just have to raise 0.3 to the first power, no big deal, and 0.7 to the seventh power, do that multiplication. But I'm going to use my calculator's binomial PDF function. So going to the calculator, I want to go to my distribution menu, okay, which is right above my VARS key. And I want to scroll down or scroll up, either way, to find binomial PDF. Okay, my apologies, the lighting is a little off. It's hard to see. Okay, so you want to use the PDF when X is taking on an exact value. You want to use the CDF, the cumulative distribution function, when you have a situation where you're doing like a running total. Okay, so the CDF would be used for a less than or equal to case, and it will come in handy later when I do the other two probability extra problems. All right, so I want to select Binomial PDF, and I want to put in all of the information. Okay, so the number of trials is the sample size, that's 8. The probability of success is 0.3, and the probability that I'm looking for, x taking on exactly 1, is the x value. And then scroll down and enter, and you'll see that on my home screen I have this binomial PDF, open parentheses, 8, 0.3, 1. If you have an older calculator, your calculator will go back to the screen, and in order you would put in the sample size, probability of success, and your x value. All right, so the probability that exactly one insect survives is 0.1977. That's rounding to 4 decimal places. Okay, so let's find the probability at most 3 survive. All right, so at most 3 is the same thing as saying x is less than or equal to 3. Okay, at most does include the 3. You need to be very careful with the binomial distribution because the case of equality matters, especially when the sample size is very small. All right, so one way to do this is to use the binomial PDF 4 times. Okay, the probability x is less than or equal to 3 would be equal to the probability x is equal to 0 plus the probability x is equal to 1 plus the probability x is equal to 2 plus the probability x is equal to 3. So you could either use the formula 4 times or go back and forth in your calculator 4 times finding those probabilities and adding them up. But your calculator has that binomial CDF function that does this summation for you. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. All right, so that's the binomial CDF. And it looks almost identical to the binomial PDF. So you want to be careful and make sure you get the right one. Okay, I don't know why the lighting is so terrible on this morning. Okay, so there's the PDF. You use that one when you're looking for x taking on an exact value. The CDF is for the situation where you have this running total. X is 0 up to wherever you want to stop. Okay, and it does all of that summation for you. It's going to ask for the sample size. Okay, that's 8, number of trials. Probability of success is still 0.3. And this x value here is where you're going to stop. Okay, I'm going to stop at 3. This is not saying I'm looking for the probability that x is equal to 3, because I'm using the CDF, not the PDF. So it's going to sum up all of those probabilities from x is equal to 0 up to x is equal to 3. Okay, so the probability that at most 3 survive is 0.8059, okay, rounding to 4. Okay, so fairly high probability that at most 3 survive. Last but not least for the probabilities, I want to find the probability that more than 5 survive. So the probability of more than is not going to include the 5. Okay, we want more than 5. So the probability x is greater than 5, notice I'm not using the case of equality here, is going to be equal to the probability x is greater than or equal to 6. Okay, because this is a discrete probability distribution. No values exist for x between 5 and 6. Okay, so if you want to think of this as a table, for example, we have our x values going from 0 up to 8, and then we have their corresponding probabilities. Okay, we found the probability x was exactly equal to 1 up here, so I could put that in if I wanted to, and I could fill in this entire table. Okay, but if I'm looking at something like this, the probability x is greater than or equal to 6, be a little more clear here. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. More than 6, okay, sorry, more than 5 means that I'm looking for the summation of these three probabilities here. Okay, whatever this one is, this one is, this one is. Okay, more than 5 means 6 or more. Okay, this is because we're working with a discrete probability distribution. When we get to a continuous distribution like the normal distribution, the case of equality is not going to make a difference, but you have to be very careful with this when you're using the binomial distribution. All right, so again, you could go ahead and sum up all of the individual probabilities using your binomial PDF, going back and forth to your calculator 3 times. Or you can use your binomial CDF and subtract from 1. Okay, now you wouldn't want to use your binomial CDF directly because the CDF always sums from 0 up to wherever you're telling it to stop. Okay, but if I want this summation here, I'm not starting from 0. I'm going to use the fact that if I were to sum all of these probabilities, that sum would be 1. The sum of all the probabilities in a probability distribution is 1. So I can go ahead and use my calculator CDF function and subtract from 1. So the probability x is greater than or equal to 6, which is what I'm looking for, is going to be equal to 1 minus the probability x is less than or equal to 5. And this is where I can use that CDF, because this is a summation from 0 up to 5. So in other words, I'm taking this whole thing, which is 1, and then taking out the piece that I don't want, this chunk of probability here, and it's going to give me this piece left over. Okay, so going to my calculator, I could do this pretty much in one step. Okay, it's really handy. Whoops. Okay, so I'm going to go 1 minus, and I'm going to go to my distribution menu, scroll to find binomial CDF, because I want that summation from x is equal to 0 up to x is equal to 5. Again, I apologize. I don't know why it's kind of faded here. Okay, so my sample size is still 8. My probability of success is still 0.3. This time I want to stop the summation at 5 and then press enter. So you'll see that it's doing the subtraction 1 minus the summation of those probabilities from 0 up to 5. Enter. And then I get this very small probability, 0.0113. Okay, so the sum of all of these probabilities, whatever they are, is 0.0113. This is not the probability x is exactly equal to anything. It's the probability x is equal to 6 plus the probability x is equal to 7 plus the probability x is equal to 8. Okay, last but not least, I want to just briefly talk about the mean variance and standard deviation for the binomial distribution. Okay, if you wanted to find the mean for this situation, very simple. For the binomial distribution, the shortcut formula is just n times p. So if I were to repeatedly sample 8 insects at a time, in the long run, the average number of insects that would survive would be mu. Okay, so 8 times 0.3, and that is 2.4. Sorry, I almost said 0.24. Okay, 2.4. So in the long run, on average, groups of 8 insects, 2.4 insects would survive. Okay, it's a long-term average. You can't actually get 2.4 insect. Okay, the variance for the binomial distribution is n times p times 1 minus p. Some textbooks use the letter q for 1 minus p. So 8 times 2.4. Oops, sorry. Oops. That's going to be 8 times 0.3 times 0.7. Okay, so multiplying that by 0.7, I get 1.68. And then the standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. So taking the square root of 1.68. I get 1.296. Okay, just rounding to 3 here. I could carry that out a little further if I want. So if you're looking to answer further questions using the binomial distribution and you needed the mean and standard deviation, these are the shortcut formulas specific to the binomial distribution.